a hot topic right now in Call of Duty, not only in Modern Warfare, but also in Cold War. That is skill-based matchmaking. Now, you have skill-based matchmaking, which are, matches you against people who are roughly of your skill level, but there's also, of course, team balancing in itself that is added into the equation to try to overall influence whether or not you are going to win or lose your game before you even play it, in fact. I mean, a lot of times they put you on a team that basically have a 0.01% chance to win, and they're like, all right, well, we'll give them this guy. It gives them a 1% chance to win now. Either way, they're looking for a miracle. Now, I start off this game. I'm going to do a bigger project on this later on with CLG, but I figured this was a great example. I start off, I'm using an MP5 and a Tundra class. Now, I mainly just want to use the Tundra. I'm trying to level it up. It's only level like 6 right now, and then I realized I have an AK-74U, and I switched to that instead of the MP5 because I'm not trying to sweat on people. I want to get some kills. I want to level up a gun. And Search and Destroy, granted, is not a good game mode to do that in. Not many people play Search to level up a weapon. I am one of the few because it's the game mode I like playing, so I try to level up everything in the game mode I like playing. But most people will just go play Team Deathmatch, or we're just going to go play Kill Confirmed, or just going to go play Domination, whatever. And they're just going to get 80 kills, 70 kills, 100 kills, whatever in that game mode. I mean, shoot, even in the alpha, I dropped like 100-something kill games. So it's not that difficult to boost a weapon up if you're doing that. But I get into this game. I'm playing with Wildcat. I'm only in a party of two. We've been playing most of the night. Some games try hard, some games not. This game stuck out as ridiculous. We got into this game, and it all I could hear, literally all the shots I was listening to, and you guys are going to hear the gameplay soon, was just like burst weapons. You just heard AUGs and M16s being shot the entire time. It was legitimately a 6v6 game battles burst rifle match. And there was a couple of, like I had an MP5 on. I had an MP5 on as well. There's a couple snipers, but overall, in general, it was like, dude, every weapon I was listening to was a burst rifle being shot. And they are very good in Search and Destroy. And I think it's good for a couple reasons. One is they one burst and pretty successfully. They were actually nerfed today. But also, because of the health pool in the game and the fact that the game has stims as well, if you try to full off, like just full auto somebody, they move out of the way just like that guy did to me, and I just heal back to full health right away. Instantly, I'm back to 150. The health pool is too high, and stims are too good. And because of that, it just makes it so you have to use a gun like a sniper or an M16 or a shotgun. Weapons that will basically guarantee you a kill. It won't just weaken the player. You're not going to see, I feel like, a ton of full auto weapons being dominant unless they're close range full auto weapons. Then they can't get away. But the FFAR, the AK, I think they're great guns. They're very strong. I feel like they're going to struggle to pick people off like you would need in Search and Destroy to get some decent kills. So they just run away. They stim. They're back to full health. But either way, this was a game. We had a bunch of sweaty kids. Everybody's like prestige. You know, a party of four. We have a party of like three or four on the other team as well. Every single soul in the game is AUGing and M16ing. And if you're trying to enjoy the game, maybe it's a combination of skill-based matchmaking, a combination of the game mode itself. It's extremely difficult to go play Search and use anything but the best shit, which is really unfortunate for content creation because I don't want to just use three or four or five guns all year long. That's a bigger variety than normal. Granted, I think I could get away using the FFAR, the AUG, the M16, the MP5, even the Milano, or, you know, there's a variety of weapons, but there are a couple weapons that very obviously stick out as the best as well. Get a lot of Tundra kills, though, which is good. I'm happy about that. I still need to level it up a lot. It's really low level. And I have, like, nothing unlocked. I don't have anything for ADS speed. I have nothing for flinch resistance. And they nerfed snipers today as well. A lot of weapon balancing going out early right now in Cold War. And I know a lot of people on my channel right now probably are not interested in watching it. That's kind of how it works with the new Call of Duty. Some people love it. Some people don't. I guarantee I'll lose some viewers for it. But in the end, I'm going to play what I'm enjoying. Right now, I am enjoying Cold War more than Modern Warfare. Maybe that changes in the future. Maybe. But no guarantee. All right, I'll let you guys listen to the game audio for the rest of the game, and I will do a more in-depth thing with skill-based matchmaking in the future, more testing and stuff. So I hope you look forward to that as well. Thank you for watching. Enjoy. But he used three guns. We all switched.
And a chance to do some goofy, dumb shit.
Yeah. Kill cams, you know, some fun shit. That's why I told you guys, Fortnite was just a better game. Bomb acquired. Call of Duty doesn't get it. And then Fortnite didn't get it either.
We are pulling ahead.
Yeah, I have the answer to your fucking AUG now, bastard. Level up my Tundra.
Oh, he's one shot on top of the satellite thingy.
He dropped down and then burst me with an AUG again. Didn't like the AUG? No, I mean, I can use the AUG. You've obviously watched me drop tons of 20 kill games under the AUG. It's just boring. My opinion. I'm using the AUG too. No, I'm not. I had an MP5 and a sniper.
I'm wide peeking this quick and not missing.
He's dead. You're good. Look, yeah, fuck him. He's gone.
That was the nastiest snipe I've hit in this game yet.
Let him know.
Fucking filthy.
And I'm dead. Guy peeked down low after I was watching him top. That's usually what happens. Oh, this is a four-man party.
Girthstone? You talking shit about Girthstone, dude?
1-4, 1-3. It balanced out. I'm 6-2, but I refuse to put on the good shit right now.
4-4, I'm trash. He's over there.
I can't believe I just missed that. I obviously need to retire. I'm fucking done. He's bottom B. He'll kill Girthstone in a second, because Girthstone's dog shit. He snuck past him. He'll be in our spawn.
I'm holding this angle. There's still several top right.
Spy plane flight time 50% on my mark. Mark.
Where are they at exactly? Oh, they're far back right now.
One's top middle room. Two top middle room.
I can't see. I can't see again.
Get markered. Any flank behind spawn.
Wow, another AUG, right? That's so fun, interesting. Like I said, back to the AUG. Woo. Everyone.
Holds the objective.
Use the same shit. Really fun.
No way is he under there with a shotgun, bro! Okay, I just can't get anything going. This guy's knifing only.
Naturally, he's our teammate, so...
never mind, he does have an AUG, but... I guess he prefers the knife. I have 4 kills, 1,000 damage. Alright, he's doing something.
Oh, this gun is really weird. Is it a glitch?
He's probably gonna go bottom B, go if not back towards the spawn.
He went low. Oh man, it's almost like this is a good weapon. Let's just all fucking use it together.
That kid shotgunned me.
Switching rally point.
points.
Can't wait to get it for Christmas. It's all right. If you won't ever get into a lobby with people like me if you get it for Christmas. I haven't seen a Christmas noob in like 6 years in Call of Duty, so.
Liquidate all objectives.
The matchmaking system makes sure of that.
We got the bomb. We've taken the lead.
Top of the building still.
I'll watch top mid in a second here.
How does he have time to run in there, plant that, and then run away somewhere?
He didn't. He threw it from outside the room, I think is where he put it.
Bomb dropped.
Bomb's dead. He's hiding behind the tent.
The guy just running around trying to knife.
No, we're one night off. We're up, actually. We're winning? What the fuck?
Yeah, I did not think we were fucking winning. I didn't think so either. I've just been getting shit on.
Half our team is double to triple negative.
I just can't finish a kill.
That's the full auto syndrome right there. Every time you have full auto weapons, it gives people time to regen and run, and they just stay healthy, and you can't fucking do anything about it.
We are taking
down low, one shot, jumped up!
Good call. How does he have an angle?
Because he stood up on top of the tank and you didn't check it.
I slid past and I thought I could watch the stairs. I didn't think he could see me from there.
Switching rally
10
points.
Kills, 1900 damage. 400 more damage than I should have.
5 kills, 1000 damage.
Aug is insane. That's why we're playing a 6v6 fucking AIDS, AIDS match again, dude. Matchmaking's horrible. It's fucking horrible. Unfun. Everyone dick rides the same shit and there's nothing you can do about it. Other than not play the game. Because if you try to use a gun that's not the best, you're going to get by the guns that are the best.
We're in the lead.
We got our whole fucking team is using jammers. Get dumpster, you trash can.
Bomb is armed. Mop up the survivors and come home.
Area secured.
I think there's a lot of strong guns. The problem is that just the way the health system works with stims and shit, they're not strong enough to kill people before they can get away and just instantly full heal. The FFAR, pretty strong. AK, pretty strong. But realistically, you're just gonna fucking weaken somebody. They slide out of the way. The game's lagginess and fucking weird shit. They slide. Once they slide out of view, they're full health again within 1 second.